Nomura Global Markets Research lowers its inflation forecast for the Philippines. It now predicts the consumer price index at 5.3% this year from the previous 5.8% projection. Nomura said the downward revision is due to the lower than expected inflation readings over the past 2 months. It also trimmed its core inflation forecast to 5.7% from 5.9%. It, however, warned core inflation may remain elevated in the coming months. Headline inflation slowed to 6.6% in April from 7.6% in March. The Development Bank of the Philippines decries the alleged railroading of its planned merger with Land Bank. The DBP said in a statement it is deeply concerned about the palpable efforts to railroad the merger and create public confusion that will be completed by November. The DBP on April 18th submitted an appeal to the Office of the President on a claim of the Governance Commission for Good Government and Owned and Controlled Corporations, or GCG, that the merger would not need a new law passed in Congress. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno told reporters last week Malacanang may issue an executive order this month approving the union. The Philippine government's total outstanding debt rises to a record 13.86 trillion pesos in March. That is over 104 billion pesos compared to the previous month. The government borrowed heavily to finance the country's COVID response. In 2022, the country's debt to GDP ratio stood at 60.9%, which is considered by global standards as high. For an economist, the current debt level calls for more efforts to ensure faster GDP growth.
Walang mali sa paghiram. Ang mahalaga ay nagagamit ng maayos yung resources na hinihiram natin, whether sa abroad or dito sa mga taga-Pilipinas. Marami naman pong inisyatibo ang gobyerno, pero pag tinignan natin side by side, no, sa ating mga kapitbahay dito sa ASEAN, nakikita natin na naiiwan pa rin, no? So mahalaga talaga, no? Pinag-aralan namin ito, no? Mahalagang mahalaga na mapalago ang ekonomiya nang mas mabilis, yeah. At ang pinakamahalagang elemento dito ay ang kumpiyansa ng mga namumuhunan.
Finance leaders of the Group of Seven economies set to meet in Japan this week. Tokyo's finance chief Shunichi Suzuki says they will discuss ways to strengthen the global financial system after the collapse of several banks in the U.S. Local media report they will also discuss individual emergency measures in case of digital bank runs. Suzuki is chairing that meeting to be held in the city of Niigata from May 11 to 13. A raft of data releases from the world's second largest economy. China's imports sharply contract in April, reinforcing signs of a fragile domestic demand despite the lifting of its COVID curbs. Inbound shipments were down 7.9% to $205 billion after it sank by 1.4% in March. Exports, meanwhile, grew at a slower pace at 8.5% to $295 billion from a 14.8% increase. It's not all bad, though, as China reported a better-than-expected trade surplus of $90 billion. Economists at Goldman Sachs attribute the lighter trade in April to residual seasonality after China's Lunar New Year celebration. Aside from trade figures, Beijing is also set to release its inflation data this week, with analysts expecting the CPI to slow at 0.3%. Here's how investors are reacting to China's economic data. Stocks in Asia settle in mixed territory on Tuesday. Chinese markets reacted negatively to the new figures, with Hong Kong's Hang Seng shedding 1.7%. The ASX 200 also seeing a modest loss ahead of Australia's announcement of its first budget surplus in 15 years. Over in Europe, futures point to a lower open. UK markets are reopening after a public holiday from the coronation of King Charles III. Meanwhile, Wall Street could also see a weaker session as investors await the release of the US April inflation figures. Trading resumes tonight, Manila time.